Praise the Lord, everybody. Praise the Lord, everybody. Hallelujah. As we prepare ourselves for service, I'm just going to ask if we'll go into a time of prayer. If I can get the ministers that are able to just begin to walk the sanctuary, let's just declare the glory of the Lord, the presence of the Lord, the power of the Lord. As we go into worship, hallelujah, we just thank God for his goodness and his mercy. The musicians are going to lead us in praise through the instruments, and as they play, let's worship God. Let's just prepare an atmosphere for deliverance. Let's prepare an atmosphere for souls to be saved. We thankful God for the one that was already baptized. We are excited about what God is doing. Come on, let's just prepare our hearts to receive the word. We be prepared to go into worship, because when the saints worship together, we begin to experience the supernatural power of God is in the place of unity. He commands the blessing. So just join us in this time of prayer and worship as we just declare hallelujah. We just declare the glory of the Lord. How we declare the glory of the Lord. We declare the glory of the Lord. So as the musicians pray, how to play, and as the ministers praise, hallelujah, come on, join us in, and we'll go into this worship experience together.
In Jesus' name, God, we thank you for your glory in the sanctuary. God, we thank you for your glory in the sanctuary. God, we thank you for your glory in the sanctuary. God, we thank you for your glory in the sanctuary. God, we thank you because your presence is in the room. God, we thank you because when you show up, healing shows up. When you show up, deliverance show up. When you show up, strength shows up. When you show up, salvation shows up. When you show up, help shows up. God, we thank you because we have an expectation that healing is going to manifest. We have an expectation that your glory is going to saturate the room. God, we have an expectation that deliverance will manifest. God, we have an expectation. So God, be glorified in this place. God, show up and show out in this place. God, lift every burden in this place. God, meet every need in this place. God, strengthen the weak is our prayer. Heal the sick, oh my God. You are a great physician. Heal now in Jesus' name. God, we thank you for the soul that went down in the watery grave. Oh God, you're still calling. You're still drawing. You're still saving. God, we thank you. God, we thank you. Now be glorified is our prayer. Come on, if you love him, just send up a praise. Hallelujah. Thank you for his presence. Thank you for his anointing. Thank you for his mercy. Thank you for his grace. God, we thank you. God, we adore you. God, we honor you. God, we bless your name. Oh, God, we love your goodness. We love your mercy. We love you, God. We love him. Come on, if you love him, praise him. Come on, if you love him, praise him. If you praise him, he'll show up. If you praise him, the singers will sing easy. If you praise him, preaching will be easy. If you praise him, his glory will manifest. Every need met. Woo! My God. Do me a favor. God woke me up about 4 o'clock this morning, and all I heard God say is, my peace is with them. My peace is with them. I don't know what I was dreaming about. I don't know what I was thinking about. But when I got up, all I heard God saying is, my peace is with them. Now do me a favor. Just tell your neighbor, walk in God's peace. Come on, walk in God's peace. Hallelujah. Tell your other neighbor, walk in God's peace. I don't know who's troubled this morning, but walk in God's peace. He says, my peace I give to you. My peace I leave with you. Hallelujah.
Oh, come on, sing up a sound of worship in this room. Oh, yeah. We worship you, Lord. We adore your name. We give you the glory. We give you the glory. In this room, come on, let your sound resonate all over this building. We worship you, Lord. There's nobody like you, Jesus. Nobody like you, Jesus. We worship you, Lord. Hallelujah. We give you the glory. Come in, oh God. Come in. Come into this room and have your way. Come into this room and do whatever it is that you see fit, that you want to do. It's what I do. No matter what's going on, no matter what the enemy tries to do, praise is what I, come on, let it ring out. What I do, what I do. Come on, it's what I do. Yeah, it's what you do. It's who you are. Come on, sing it again. Praise is what I do. Oh, oh, yeah, yeah. Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah. Sing. It's what I do.
It's what I do.
Lift your hands. Sing it again. Praise.
Praise is what I do.
Sing it out. It's what I,
it's what I do.
Now if that's who you are, can you give him a shout of praise in this room? Come on. Come on. You're just there. You're just about there. Come on. Can you give him a shout of praise in this room? Come on. It's what you do. In spite of your circumstances, it's what you do. In spite of what it looks like, it's what you do. In spite of what comes against me, it's what I will do. I vow to praise you through the good, through the bad, through the ugly, whether I'm up, whether I'm down, whether I'm sad, whether I'm happy, I vow to praise you. Come on, I vow to praise you. I vow to praise you through the good and the bad. Praise is what I do. Praise is who I am. It's what I was created to do. And I'm just here on this earth just to practice what I'm going to do in heaven. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Oh, Jesus. We bless your name, Lord, yes. Oh, Jesus. We bask in your presence, Lord. We feel your presence. We feel your presence. You're doing a new thing in us. You're doing a new thing in us. Oh, do a new thing. Do a new thing. Do a new thing. Do a new thing. Refresh our minds, Jesus. You have rescued, you have rescued my life. You have rescued, you have rescued my life. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you for saving me. Thank you for rescuing my life from the things I thought I wanted. You rescued me, and I praise your name. Can you lift your hands all over this room? Let's just go a little further. Just worship him. Come on. Open up your mouth and say something sweet to the Lord. Come on, praise him. Lift up your voice in Judah first. Come on. Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah. We need you, Lord. Here. You have rescued my life. You have rescued my life. And I'm never going back. Woo! You have rescued my life. You have rescued my life. And I'm never my response is hallelujah. You're my redeemer. Hallelujah. Can you sing with me? My response. My response. Come on, I hear you. Hallelujah. You're my redeemer. Hallelujah. Can you sing that one more time for me? Let it permeate this room. My response is, come on, tell them. Hallelujah. Yes, you're my redeemer. Hallelujah. You got one more time. Come on, sing it again. My response is, with uplifted hands is hallelujah. You're my redeemer, my savior, my Lord, my King. Hallelujah. Let's go from the top. You ready? Come on. You have rescued my life. Come on. You have rescued my life. Sing it out. And I'm You have rescued my, and I'm never going back. You have rescued my life. Thank you for rescuing my life, and I'm never going back. Can we sing it all together? You have rescued my life. And I'm never, 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 never going back. I give you my will, I give you my life, Lord.
You have rescued my life.
Cause you have rescued my life.
You have rescued my life.
Not my will, but thy will be done. No. You have,
you have,
what a mighty, mighty, mighty God we serve.
Going back.
See, my response is,
hallelujah.
Say, my response is. Saving my life. Sing it again. My response is.
Hallelujah.
You're my redeemer. Say it again. You're my redeemer.
You're my redeemer.
Is it? You're my redeemer.
You're my redeemer.
I know who I was before. Cause you're my redeemer.
You're my
I know what I could have been in. You're my redeemer.
You're my redeemer.
I know what I wanted to be in. You're my redeemer.
You're my redeemer.
I could have lost my mind, but you're my
you're
redeemer.
My redeemer.
A long time ago.
You're my redeemer.
Hallelujah.
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 Rescued,
you have rescued my life.
Sing it out.
You have rescued
last
my
time.
Life.
And I'm never. Come on, lift it up all over this room. Come on. Lift it up to your Redeemer, your Savior, your mighty fortress. Hallelujah.
Rescue anybody. He's rescued my life. He saved me from the pits of hell. My response is hallelujah. 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 He's my redeemer. Lord, I thank you for rescuing my life. Any witnesses in the building today? Did he rescue anybody? Thank you. Hallelujah. Thank you for saving me. Thank you. Thank you.
Mighty, mighty, mighty.
Come on, give him praise for saving you. You could have been lost in a world of sin. Thank you. your response always be? Hallelujah. Somebody cry hallelujah. 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 Bible says, I will call upon the Lord who is worthy to be praised, and so shall I be saved from my enemies. He rescued me, y'all. He rescued me.
Yeah.
Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. I will. Hallelujah. Late in the midnight hour. I will. Things not going right. I will. Hallelujah. Call upon him. Hallelujah. For there is nobody like our God. I'll give him all the glory. And I will honor his name. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. I will call on him. Hallelujah. For he's the God of my salvation. Hallelujah. Hey, hallelujah. Oh God, hallelujah. I thank you that I can call on you. Hallelujah. When I need you, God, hallelujah. And you'll show up right on time. I will call upon the Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Nobody like our God. Hallelujah. I will call upon the Lord. Hallelujah. I give honor to God this morning, who is the head of my life. Hallelujah. I thank him, hallelujah, for all that he is to me, everything that he has done for me. Hallelujah. I give honor to our leaders, Bishop Samuel Hampton, Elder Miranda Hampton, hallelujah. What an awesome man and woman of God, hallelujah. To our assistant pastor, Pastor Eugene Wilson and his lovely wife, Lady Sarah, hallelujah. To our associate pastor, hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. I give honor to Dr. Nolan as well and her spouse, hallelujah. To all the ministers, elders, deacons, and everyone in their respective places, the saints, to everyone I say, praise the Lord this morning. Hallelujah. It is not my intention to be before you long this morning. God has given me a word for the house. It's my intention to deliver that word and move right on out the way. Hallelujah. So today I'm going to ask that you turn with me to 1 Kings chapter 19. We're going to begin reading at verse 1. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. We bless you in this place, and we honor you in this place. And it reads as thus, And Ahab told Jezebel all that Elijah had done, and withal how he had slain all the prophets with the sword. Then Jezebel sent a message unto Elijah, saying, So let the gods do to me and more also, if I make not thy life as the life of one of them by tomorrow about this time. And when he saw that, he arose and went for his life and came to Beersheba, which belongeth to Judah, and left his servant there. But he himself went a day's journey into the wilderness and came and sat down under a juniper tree. And he requested for himself that he might die and said, It is enough. Now, O Lord, take away my life, for I am not better than my fathers. And as he lay and slept under a juniper tree, behold, then an angel touched him and said unto him, Arise and eat. And he looked, and behold, there was a cake baking on the coals and a cruse of water at his head. And he did eat and drink and laid him down again. I'm going to stop right there. Isaiah 43 and 19. Behold, I will do a new thing. Now it shall spring forth. Shall ye not know it? I will even make a way in the wilderness and rivers in the desert. My topic for this morning is,
even now, God is still your promise keeper. Just tap into your benefits. Our bishop, over the course of this month, has given us the theme of the benefits of a new life. So if I may, just for a short moment, speak to you by way of an example of one who had given his life to God and was willing to do whatever God instructed him to do. I've come today to offer some encouragement to those who have been walking according to God's will, doing what God has told you to do, and living according to how God has instructed you to live. Sometimes while you're on this journey, it can seem a bit heavy and oftentimes lonely. Is there anyone in the room who has ever felt like you were all alone and walking this thing out by yourself? In this season that we are currently living in, there is so much going on all around us. It seems the enemy has become unflinching in what he will do and what he will do to the people of God. So much so that it has begun to place the people of God in fear for their lives, feeling isolated, alone, and sometimes even ostracized on your jobs, in your neighborhoods, and even with your very own family members. Is there anyone in the room this morning who has, in this season, felt like you were in a position where you were all by yourself, surrounded by the enemy himself? No one you could talk to, no one you could call on, or nowhere you could look to, just by yourself. But even though you are alone, you have an understanding of who God is. You know that he is the all-powerful one. You know that he is a deliverer. You know that you have seen him move. You have seen him bring out. And you have even seen him set the captive free. But not only that, you understand the anointing and you know that you are chosen by him. Somebody say, I've been handpicked by God himself. Yes. Yet you feel like you're on an island all by yourself. You're tired, worn down, worn out, and on the verge of breaking down mentally, emotionally, and yes, even your body has begun to exhibit symptoms of what you're going through in your atmosphere. Physically, you're worn down. Is there anyone in the house today who can identify with what I'm talking about? God, if you don't step in quick, I feel like I'm going to lose it. I just feel like I'm in the midst of a crowded room, but I'm all by myself. I see your mama. I see your daddy. I see your sister. I see your brother. I even see my spouse. But right now, I don't think they can comprehend where I'm at mentally. I just feel like I'm all by myself. But today, God sent me in the room to tell the people of God that he is still your promise keeper. And there's some benefits that you have that you've got to tap into. Look at your neighbor and tell him, God is still my promise keeper. And because he has planted you in the palm of his hand, there is no man that can pluck you from that safe place in him. God has sent me this morning to address those who are feeling like they are ready to just throw in the towel. God has sent me to refute the spirit of suicide in this room today. It's been lurking in the corners. It's been talking to you at your mind at night. It's been trying to tell you, you ought to just give up and let go. But God said, not so today. Your promise keeper. God has sent me to call out that spirit of despair and hopelessness, that spirit of loneliness that is trying to get you to do some things that you wouldn't ordinarily do. God said, I am your promise keeper. I am. He sent me this morning to the house with a word of encouragement to make you aware that he has not forgotten about you. And in the midst of everything that is going on around you, he is still your promise keeper. And you got some benefits. He sent me to let you know that no matter how rough your circumstance, your predicament or situation might be, he said, tell my people that I have not forgotten them. Mama and daddy might fail you. Sister and brother might fail you. Your job might even fail you. Your bank account might look real bleak right now. But God said, I am your promise keeper. Doesn't matter what it looks like. Doesn't matter what it seems like. I am a God who can deliver. I am a God who can set free. I am a God who will bring you out. I am the promise keeper. He never fails. God does not function based upon what it looks like and what seems to be logical. He is a God that will confound your mind. When the enemy says you should be dead, God says live. When the enemy says you should be in lack, God says, I will provide for you. God, I need you to step in the room today and restore the faith of my brothers and sisters. Step in the room today, God, and restore hope. Step in the room and restore strength. Let them know, God, I am your promise keeper. God said, I see what you have been doing. I see that you have not let down the standard. I see that regardless of what everyone else may be doing around you, that you are yet holding up the bloodstained banner. I see how you have honored my word in the midst of those who are godless people. I see your stand, and I want you to know that even now I am still your promise keeper. I am not slack concerning my promises. That which I said I will do, that I will do. Lay your hands on your chest and tell yourself, God is my promise keeper. He is, he is, he is. Let's go to the text. As God dropped this scripture in my spirit, I began questioning the direction God was taking me in with this scripture. I said, I know what the bishop is saying, and I know what he wants us to teach on throughout this month. I said, God, how do I connect those two? And so as God began to connect the dots, he took me back a few chapters. And as I began to study, I realized that God on multiple occasions had made provision for his prophets and Elijah. He covered them when the enemy was trying to take them out. So in my studies, God took me back to the point and time where the kingdom was divided. Although there were many events surrounding the division, it all boiled down to Solomon loving many strange women and them turning his heart from God. The prophet Ahijah shows up on the scene while Jeroboam, and I'm trying to give you the abbreviated version. He shows up on the scene when Jeroboam is wearing this new garment and tears the garment into 12 pieces. As he and Jeroboam are out in the field, he tells Jeroboam to take 10 pieces of the garment because the Lord is about to take the kingdom out of Solomon's hand. And he is going to place 10 tribes under your leadership. He further states that 2 tribes, Judah and Benjamin, will be left for the sake of David and Jerusalem, 1 each. The Bible tells us that because Israel had forsaken God and worshiped idol gods, I want to name just a few for you. Ashtoreth, the goddess of the Zidonians, representing the nature, fertility, and sexual love. Be careful who you align yourself with. Chemosh, the God of the children of Ammon, was known to be the destroyer and was their god of war. They believed he could bring them victory and often would make human sacrifices to this false god. Be careful who you align yourself with, because there's only one God that can give you victory, and that's God himself. Milcom, the god of the children of Ammon, represents child sacrifice. Can you imagine being a child and your parents worship the god of Ammon, and you got to be worried about whether they coming in to take you from your bed and sacrifice you to this god? They got mixed up with those nations that God told them not to mix and mingle with at that time. time, and they when they conquered the land. Long story short, when Solomon dies, Israel rebels against his son Rehoboam. And Jeroboam becomes king over the 10 tribes as Ahijah prophesied he would. So as we go down through the years, each king of the northern kingdom becomes worse than the king before and follows in Jeroboam's footsteps and not David's. They worship idols. They did all types of sexual sins. They were immoral in all of their actions and deeds. Things ran rampant in the kingdom that were unlike God. We then come to King Ahab, who the Bible says did more to provoke the Lord God of Israel to anger than all the kings of Israel that were before him. The Bible tells us he took a wife whose name was Jezebel. She was the daughter of the king of the Zidonians. Now remember, the Zidonians were wrapped up in sexual sins, and they worshiped Baal, which is also associated with Beelzebub and demonic activity. For those who do not know, Beelzebub is one of the seven deadly demons or seven princes of hell. He represents gluttony and envy and is known as the Lord of Dung and the Lord of the Flyers or the Flies. So now this is who Ahab has connected himself and the rest of the children of Israel to. Be careful who you connect with and align yourself with, because their ways and ideology will become your ways. Birds of a feather do flock together. You might not start out being demonic, but baby, they're going to keep trying to pull you on in. Be careful who you align yourself to in this season. So God sends Elisha in to tell King Ahab, there shall not be dew nor rain in the coming years. No dew and no rain means that famine and death are coming to the land. God is saying to his people, I need your attention, and I need it now. Ahab was not king over some heathen nation. He was king over God's chosen people. And he aligned himself with all kinds of demonic forces. And God said, I got to come in and get your attention. So sometimes when things are happening in our lives, they're happening because God said, I want your attention. I need your attention, and I need it now. Elder Miranda talked last Sunday about us aligning ourselves and getting ready for what God is going to do. In order for us to get ready with everything that's been happening in the house, the anointing that's been flowing through the house, God said, I want your attention. I need your attention. You want to go to the next level? Give your attention to God. Let him have your attention. Let him have your eyes. Let him have your ears. Let him have your thoughts. Let him have your mind. So Elijah goes on the run because Jezebel starts killing prophets of the Lord. Yet God, being the promise keeper that he is, yet provides for and takes care of Elijah. Whatever you do in this season, make sure you stand for God. Whatever you do in this season, make sure you stand for God. Because whatever the enemy tries to bring your way, God is going to cover you. And God is going to keep you. Have you ever been in a situation that you know only God could have made the provision for you and for your family? That only God could have turned this situation around. Only God could have saved my life and brought me out of that pit. Only God could have healed my body. God said, sends him to live by the brook Kereth, and he sends the raven to feed him bread and flesh in the morning and the evening. Somebody say, he is still my promise keeper. No matter what the situation looks like, no matter what the situation seems like, God is still my promise keeper. But then the brook dries up. So what happens when the provision that God has been giving dries up? God is trying to tell you, I need your attention. I need you to follow me. If I did it before, I will do it again. Don't you worry. Don't you fret. So when the brook dries up, God sends him to Zarephath, where he finds a widow woman who is going to feed him out of this bottomless barrel of meal. Yeah, she was ready to make a cake for her and her son so that they could die. But God said, not so, because I got a man of God. I got a woman of God coming your way, and I need you to sustain them. God is able, no matter what you're going through, no matter what it looks like, trust God, because he is still your promise keeper. God has sent me to the house to remind the people of God that he is yet a promise keeper, and he will not allow you to be made ashamed. So as we come to this passage of scripture that I read in your hearing this morning, Elijah is running for his life, literally. God had just moved through him in a mighty way in the preceding chapter. Elijah had just been victorious in a battle against 450 prophets of Baal. Elijah challenged them to a battle to declare who was really God. He said, let us both prepare a sacrifice, and whichever God answers by fire, let him be God. The Bible tells us that all day long, the prophets of Baal worshiped. They danced, they twirled, they did all kinds of stuff while calling on their false gods. Sometimes the enemy can seem so loud all around you. And in those moments, the enemy is trying to make you feel like there is no one else on your team. And you got to be crazy and out of your mind to think you're going to win this one. But my mind goes to Psalm 25, where David says, unto thee, O Lord, do I lift up my soul. My God, I trust in thee. Let me not be ashamed. Let not mine enemies triumph over me. Lead me in thy truth and teach me, for thou art the God of my salvation. On thee do I wait. 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 God, I'm waiting on you all the day. Even right now, God is still your promise keeper. When the odds seems to be stacked against you, when the outcome does not look favorable, when it seems like the enemy is about to win, God has sent me today to tell the people of God to hold on to your promise. Don't forget your benefits package. It includes your deliverance. Don't forget your benefits package. It includes good health. Don't forget your benefit package. It includes wealth. Don't forget, you got a benefit package, baby. And all you got to do is tap into it. Somebody shout, I'm about to tap in. My God. The Bible tells us the prophets of Baal went so far as to cut on themselves in hopes that their little G God would answer and consume their sacrifice. As they did this, Elijah waited all day long. What did the word say, y'all? Lead me in thy truth and teach me, for thou art the God of my salvation. On thee do I wait all day. Sometimes we have got to be still and just wait on God. If God sent you to it, he will deliver you from it. Even now, with how it looks, even now, with how it seems, he's still your promise keeper. Elijah prepared his sacrifice, and he had them to soak the sacrifice 3 times. Y'all, it was so waterlogged that the water they soaked the sacrifice with created a water-filled trench around the sacrifice. The Bible says that Elijah prayed to God, and this is what he prayed. There was no great exploits being done, no grand gestures coming from Elijah, no grand ceremony, but he prayed a simple prayer. They gave him access to his benefit package. Elijah prays, Lord God of Abraham, Isaac, and of Israel, let it be known this day that thou art God in Israel, and that I am thy servant, and that I have done all these things at thy word. I've worked for you, God, day and night. When you got me up out my bed and told me to fall on my face and begin to pray, God, I did it all the day. I've been serving you, been walking uprightly before you. And then he goes on and says, hear me, O Lord, hear me, that this people may know that thou art the Lord God. Baby, it ain't about you, but it is about your God, and that thou hast turned their heart back again. The Bible says that once Elijah finished this simple prayer, the fire of the Lord fell and consumed not only the sacrifice, but the wood, the stones, the dust, and licked up even the water. Licked it up all around that was in the trench that surrounded the sacrifice. And even now, God is still your promise keeper, and he's about to make good on his promises to you. My God. Elijah, after all this, have you ever done some great things? Been through something? God has spoken to you. Some great things have happened. And then you turn around and look, and it feels like you're in a fight for your life. Elijah was in despair in this moment. The Bible said he asked the Lord to die. He was about ready to give up and throw in the towel. But God, being the promise keeper that he is, sent an angel to feed him and sustain him in his hour of need. As a child of God, just like the company you work for, you got a benefit package. And I'm running close to my end. If I may give you just 7 of the benefits that you have access to walk in. Number 1, God the deliverer. Psalms 34, 4-5. I sought the Lord and he heard me and delivered me from all my fears. They looked unto him and were lightened, and their faces were not ashamed. This poor man cried, and the Lord heard him and saved him out of all his troubles. God is your deliverer. All you got to do is trust him. All you got to do is believe in him. All you got to do is know that his word shall not fail. All you got to know is that every promise in the book is yea and amen. If you trust him, if you believe him, if you seek him, if you stay close to him, he will be your deliverer. God is my promise keeper. Number 2, God my provider. Philippians 4:19. But my God shall supply all your needs according to his riches in glory by Christ Jesus. Whatever your need is, whatever it is you have need of, if your cupboard is empty, God can fill it. If you need a job, God will give you a job. If you need money in your bank account to do some of the things that God has called you to do. God can fill up your bank account. If you need health in your body, God can make you well. If you trust him, if you believe him, God is your provider. He shall provide. Number three, God my sustainer. Isaiah 40 and 31. But they that wait upon the Lord shall renew their strength. They shall run and not be weary. They shall walk and not faint. Ah, if you just learn to be still and wait on God. If you learn just to sit down and trust that he shall come through. If you just learn to lay in your bed at night and just call on him. He will bring what you need. He will do what you need. All you got to do is just learn to wait on him. He's going to bring your strength. Ah, the Bible tells us that they shall mount up with wings like an eagle. Ah, God's gonna give you wings like an eagle. What does an eagle do? An eagle doesn't walk on the ground. An eagle doesn't fly low, but it goes up real high and it soars above all the problems. Sometimes you can be in a situation and you should be feeling bad, but if you trust God, he'll give you wings like an eagle and you can soar above the problem. Learn how to wait on him, but learn how to trust him, because he is, hallelujah, your supplier. Number four, God my power supply. Isaiah 40 and 28. Has thou not known? Has thou not heard that the everlasting God, the Lord, the creator of the ends of the earth, fainteth not, neither is weary. There is no searching of his understanding. He giveth power to the faint, and to them that have no might, he increases strength. Don't you know that God is your power supply? Whatever you need, if you just plug into him, if you just plug into the power supply, you can get whatever you need. You ever seen that light sitting on the table at your house? When you go into the house, you can flip the switch all you want to, but if somebody then went by and took the cord out the power supply, you will get no light. You will have no electricity. But baby, I'm here to tell you today, if you plug into God, you got all the power that you need. Power to call things that are not as though they were. Power to say that I'm healed. Power to say that I'm delivered. And that which you speak out of your mouth, when you've been plugged into the power supply, it shall come to pass. God is my promise keeper. He is. Number five. God, my grace. Sometimes we need his grace. 2 Corinthians 12 and 9. And he said unto me, my grace is sufficient for thee. For my strength is made perfect in your weakness. Sometimes we get weak. Sometimes we get weary. But God said, my grace is sufficient. His grace will pick us up and carry us softly to and fro wherever we need to go. Sometimes when we feel like we want to give in, when we feel like we want to give up, we're riding on God's grace. Oh, when things are happening all around us and we feel like we can't take it no longer, God said, my grace is sufficient. My grace will hold you up. My grace will keep you standing. My grace will keep you going. My grace is sufficient. Anybody need a little bit of grace? Yeah. My grace. Number six, and then I got one more. God, my refuge and fortress. Psalms 91, 1 through 2. He that dwelleth in the secret place of the Most High shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty. I will say of the Lord, He is my refuge and my fortress, my God. In Him will I trust. Sometimes you got stuff happening all around you. Like Elijah. He was on the run for his life, y'all. But God told him where to go. Told him what to do. If we learn to follow God, sometimes you can't think for yourself. God, make me a puppet for you. You pull my strings. You lead me. You tell me where to go. You tell me how to walk. You tell me what to do. That puppet is limp until God begins to pull the strings and God begins to lead it. Then that puppet starts walking. Then that puppet starts talking. Then that puppet starts doing. God, make me your puppet. I want to go where you tell me to go. I want to do what you tell me to do. I want to be who you call me to be. I want to say what you tell me to say. I want you to be my refuge. I want you to be my strength. Number 7. God, my light and my salvation. Psalms 27, 1 through 3. This scripture is my favorite scripture. It has special meaning for me because I was at a time in my life where I felt like I was going to lose my mind. I can identify with this because I was at a time in my life where I wanted to give up and throw in the towel. I wanted to let go of everything. I didn't care about the kids. I didn't care about nothing. I'm going to tell you the truth. I was ready to go meet my maker. I've been there. So when I talk to you about it, I know what I'm talking about. Because I know what it feels like to feel hopeless. I know what it feels like to feel like you don't have nobody to turn to. I know what it feels like. But at that moment, I'll never forget, I was standing at my kitchen sink. And I was cleaning chicken, y'all. And the Lord dropped this spirit in my, this song, this scripture in my spirit. The Lord is my light and my salvation. Whom shall I fear? The tears began to run down my face. Whatever you're facing, whatever you're going through, He said you don't have nothing to fear. The Lord is the strength of my life. Of whom shall I be afraid? When the wicked, even your enemies and your foes, came upon you to eat up your flesh, He said, I'm going to make them stumble and I'm going to make them fall, because I am your promise keeper. I am the God of your salvation. I am your light. I am your strength. And though a host should encamp against me, my heart does not need to fear. Though war shall rise against me, and this will I be confident. He is the promise keeper. He is the promise keeper. He is your deliverer. He is your way out. He is your way through. That which He said He's going to do, He shall do. Don't you worry. Don't you fret. God will not fail you. If you trust Him, if you believe Him, point your hands to yourself. My promise keeper. My promise keeper. God is my promise keeper. Whatever I need, God has got it. Whatever I want, God has got it. If I trust Him and if I believe Him, He is the promise keeper. My God. He will keep His promises. He will keep His promises. My God. I don't know who may be under the sound of my voice today that is in need of your faith in God being restored. As a child of God, you have a benefits package. And all those things that I listed, that's a part of the package. There's so much more. He's not a God that would just barely allow us to get by. The Bible tells us that the blessings of God make it one rich, and they don't add no sorrow. If you trust him, and if you believe him, and you're feeling weak, and you're feeling depleted, I want you to come now. I want you to come now. Don't hesitate. Restoration is in the house right now. Whatever you need is in the house right now. Come now. Come now. God is here. God is here. If you need restoration, if you need him to restore you, come right now. Don't wait. He is a restorer. He's a keeper. He keeps his word. He said he will not let you die. He said he's a life giver. He's a restorer of your mind. He's a restorer of your soul. He's a restorer of your heart. For those who have had their heart broken, God said, come now. I'm a restorer. And the restorer is here right now. Altar workers, come. The restorer is here right now. He's here. He's here. My God. Come now. Come now. Don't wait. Don't wait. He wants to restore your soul. He wants to restore your mind. He wants to restore your walk with him. And even those who might feel like I haven't been living what I should be living, God said, come now. I want to restore my relationship with you. He's here. He's here. He's a restorer. Yeah, yeah. He'll restore your mind. He'll restore your heart. He'll restore your soul. Let him restore your life.
You are more than able. Who am I to deny what the Lord can do?
Let him do it. Come, let him do it. Come, let him do it. Hallelujah.
You are more than able.
I hear God saying he wants to restore families. I hear God saying he wants to restore families. He wants to restore families. He wants to restore families. If you and your family are here, come, come, come. He wants to restore families. He's able. Restoration.
You are more than able. You are more than able.
You are more than able.
You are more than able.
You are. Pray, church.
Pray, church. We're calling out those spirits. 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 We're calling out those spirits unlike God right now. Every foul demon. Every foul demon. Every foul demon. We're calling out those spirits. We're calling out those spirits. We're calling out those spirits that are unlike Christ. We're calling them out. In the name of Jesus, every spirit of suicide, we're calling you out right now. In the name of Jesus, you have no power, you have no authority. We call you out. We say that the people of God shall be restored today. The people of God will receive hope today. The people of God will receive renewal today. In the name of Jesus, we bind everything that is unlike God. We bind everything that is unlike the spirit of the Holy Ghost. We speak that our people shall walk out of these doors with the newness of life, and they will tap in to what God has granted them. Lord, we thank you for health. We thank you for wealth. We thank you for spiritual fulfillment. We thank you in the name of Jesus. We call out everything that is unlike God. We call out everything that is unlike the spirit of the Holy Ghost. We say that said you shall be well. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. We call it out. Hey. Yay, God. Yay, God. Yay, God. Yay, God. Today is the day. Today is the day. Today is the day. No more hopelessness. Today is the day. No more despair. Today is the day. We shall walk in victory today. We shall walk in the newness of life. We shall walk in who we are in God. We shall walk and be the children of God. In the name of Jesus. Today, 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 right now. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Jesus. My God. My God. Send your wind, God. Send your wind, God. Send your wind, God. Oh, send your wind. Hey, send your wind, God. Yay. Send your wind, God. Blow on us, Lord. We need you now, God. Hey, send the wind, send the wind, send the wind. Send the wind, send the wind, send the wind. Strengthen us, strengthen us, strengthen us. Send the wind, send the wind, send the wind. We need you now, we need you now, we need you now. We need you now, we need you now, we need you now. We want you now, we want you now, we want you now. Send the wind, God. Send the wind, Lord. Send the wind. Send the wind. Blow on us. 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 Hallelujah. I hear God clearly. He's telling me that if there are some women in the room, I just want to wrap my arms around you. I just want to wrap my arms around you. God said you're not alone. God said you're not alone. If you're feeling alone, just come right now. Just come right now. I just want to wrap my arms around you. Hallelujah. Ooh, Jesus. God knows.
done with me yet. You're not done with me yet. There's so much more, Jesus, to this story.
Whatever you need, whatever you need, it's in the room. Whatever you need, it's in the room. Hallelujah. Whatever you need, it's in the room.
There's so much more to the story. You're not done with me yet. You're not done with me yet. You're not done with me yet. There's so much more to this story. You're not done with me yet. You're not done with me yet. You're not done with me yet. There's so much more to this story. You're not done with me yet. You're not done with me yet. You're not done with me yet. There's so much more to this story. You're not done with me yet. You're not done with me. You're not done with me yet. There's so much more to the story. You're not done with me yet.
Wait on the Lord.
Wait on the Lord.
in Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. Whatever you need. Of the enemy trying to make us feel like we're alone and we can't make it.
Thank you, Jesus.
God says, I am here. I am here.
Dear Heavenly Father, Lord, we thank you and praise you right now. For this one to become baptized in the name of Jesus. Father, we thank you right now for the word that's gone forth. Her heart has received it, Lord God. Now we pray you fill her with the Holy Spirit. Transform as she walks into newness of life. Is our prayer in Jesus' name. Amen. Hallelujah. Come on, let's give God praise on today. Come on, let's give God praise on today for the word, for the ministry. Come on, just encourage that person next to you. Tell them you got a promise keeper. Tell them God is a promise keeper. Hallelujah. God is a promise keeper. Hallelujah. Yes, he is. Yes, he is. Yes, he is. Lord, we thank you for the word. Amen. We thank God for the word, for the prayer. We thank God for what he's doing right here, even at the altar. We believe for hearts and minds being transformed as lives are being filled with the Holy Spirit. We thank God for it. Strength and comfort. We give God praise on today. Amen. 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 As we're preparing ourselves, this week of consecration is coming up. This week of consecration. So I'm asking everybody that can on tonight, if you're able to join us, we have a fellowship service here. The Abraham Temple Archdiocese, we're gathering together here at 5 o'clock p.m. So if you're able to join us, we invite you to come and join us on tonight. And then we're preparing ourselves for a week of prayer and fasting Monday through Friday, the 25th through the 29th. And so we'll be gathering at 12 noon at 7 p.m. as we're praying together, encouraged in the word together, and as we're fasting. So all those that are able, I ask you to do one meal a day with us, on one meal a day if you're able. Now if you need to take your medicine, eat a little bit with your medicine, and let's keep on praying and believing God to do supernatural things. Amen. We're believing God for healings. We're believing God for financial breakthroughs. We're believing God for restoration in families. We're believing God for transformation and minds. We've been declaring supernatural. We're declaring manifest, and we're believing, we're seeing it happen as we go through these moments. So as much as possible, join us in the temple. Those that join us virtually, we'll do our best to share some of it throughout the week. But if you're able to be in the building, be in the building. Amen. Amen. Because you don't know what God is going to do as the time of prayer and as the word and the worship goes forth. And so we're excited about it. And then on Thursday, during this week of consecration, on Thursday the 28th, we'll do communion at 12 noon and at 7 p.m. So ministers, please be properly attired and ready as we're praying and as we're hearing the word. And then we'll partake in communion. And then on Sunday, somebody shout Sunday. Sunday, fifth Sunday, March the 31st, is our Family and Friends Day, as well as Resurrection Sunday. So we do one service on that Sunday at 11:30. And so we want you to invite your family and friends to come out and be with us. And I'm asking every parent, grandparent, bring your children. We want to pray over the children. Our music ministry has a great worship experience planned. Our children, our men are participating. It's going to be a glorious time. We're sharing the word, and we're going to pray over all the children. So bring the grandbabies out. Bring them. If you got to hold them in your arm, bring them on up. We believe in God to do something supernatural as we receive the word, as we're speaking life over our children. Amen. Deacon Griggs and Sister Griggs, if you will come at this time, amen. And we've got one that we want to join into membership on today, amen. The Lord has been adding to the church, amen, here at the Faith Place, as he's adding to the body of Christ. And so we're excited. So I want to bring up Prophet Elaine Jones, amen. If she will come, amen, amen, amen. And we're welcoming her into fellowship.
Praise the Lord, Sister Jones. Do you wish to become a member of the First Apostolic Faith Church?
Yes.
Do you promise to live a life of holiness according to your Bible and the help of the Lord?
Yes.
Upon the recommendation of our pastor and your own expressed desire, it is our pleasure to welcome you to the fellowship of the First Apostolic Faith Church. Congregation, let us welcome our sister.
Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. So as we prepare ourselves to give on today, I'm going to ask Prophet Mandy if you would come. Amen. Amen. All right. Amen. Pastor Wilson, if you're able to help us out. Dr. Nolan, if you're able to help us out. All right. And Evangelist Kia, if you'll get a bottle of oil. We want to pray for everybody as they come around, those that are joining us in our time of consecration. Amen. And every time we go into consecration, we anoint you, amen, as a sign of covenant, in connection with God, to believe that God is going to do supernatural things as the saints gather together in prayer. Amen. And so if you're preparing your hearts, amen, to give on today, you see the information on the screen. You can give with your tithe and offerings in the envelope. The ushers have already shared those. You can give on Givelify. You can give electronically by right there on your phone by texting FAFC Akron to 7797. You can also give with Brother Wahee right there at the door on your with a credit card or debit card if you choose so. And even as we're preparing, I just thank God for all the wonderful guests we've been meeting on today, their first time. Can we give God praise for all?